welcome to EE473 Microwave Engineering Fall 2017, taught by Dr. Wayne Sharoma. My name is Anthony Combs, and I'm here with my crew, the Mighty Microstrips, Kayla, Jay, Kevin, and Tamara. For Project 2, our team had to design, simulate, fabricate, and test three microstrip filter designs: the low-pass stub filter, the low-pass stub filter, and the coupled-line bandpass filter. All filters were designed using 62mm Rogers RT Duroid 5880. And up first, Kevin will edify us regarding the low-pass stub filter. Kevin, take it away.
The first filter designed was a low-pass filter fabricated with stepped impedance microstrip lines. Our filter, comprised of three elements, had an attenuation of 20 dB at 8 GHz and had a cutoff frequency at 4 GHz. To design the filter, Posar's figure 8.27a, shown on the right, was used to determine the number of elements needed for a given attenuation and cutoff frequency, while table 8.4, shown on the left, was used to determine the G values needed to design the filter. From table 8.4's G values, the low-pass prototype was simulated in Microwave Office. Here is the gain and return loss of the simulated low-pass prototype. On Microwave Office, the design filter was then implemented in ideal transmission lines. The simulated gain and return loss for the ideal transmission lines is shown here. After simulating the ideal transmission lines, the filter was designed in Microstrip with uncompensated discontinuities. Shown is the gain and return loss for the filter implementation of the uncompensated discontinuities. Finally, the discontinuities were compensated. The lines were made smaller to overcome the step-in width discontinuities. Shown is the gain and return loss for the compensated filter. The physical layout for the filter was exported from Microwave Office.
Hi, this is Anthony again. Next, Jay will provide us with a forceful 411 on the low-pass stub filter. Jay? 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 Jay?
The second filter we designed was a maximally flat low-pass stub filter. The filter had four elements and an attenuation of 20 dB at 8 GHz with a cutoff frequency at 4 GHz. To design the filter, Posar figure 8.26 was used to determine the number of elements required for a given attenuation and cutoff frequency. Table 8.3 was used to determine the element values for maximally flat filters. The low-pass prototype was simulated in Microwave Office. This is the simulated gain and return loss for the low-pass prototype. Next, we designed the low-pass filter with ideal transmission line TLIN in Microwave Office. This is the simulated gain and return loss for the ideal transmission line. We replaced the ideal transmission line with the microstrip element MLIN. This is the simulated gain and return loss for the microstrip low-pass filter. To compensate the non-ideal effects of microstrip, we added discontinuity MTEE, used MLEF to model end effects of the stubs, and included taper. This is the simulated gain and return loss of the compensated low-pass filter. Finally, the physical layout was exported from Microwave Office.
Thanks, Jay. Finally, Kayla will give us the lowdown on the coupled-line bandpass.
The third filter we designed was a 3 dB ripple coupled bandpass filter. The filter was designed with four elements and a bandpass from 3.9 GHz to 4.1 GHz, with a center frequency at 4 GHz. It had an attenuation of 30 dB at 4.3 GHz. To design the filter, Posar figure 8.27b was used to determine the number of elements required for a given attenuation and cutoff frequency. Table 8.4 was used to determine the element values for the 3 dB ripple filters. We designed the low-pass filter with ideal coupled transmission lines using CLIN ADS. Shown is the simulated gain and return loss for the ideal transmission line. Using line calc, we converted the even and odd impedances into microstrip width, spacing, and lengths. We replaced the ideal transmission lines with coupled microstrip elements, MCLIN. Shown is the simulated gain and return loss for the microstrip. Non-ideal effects were added using MCFIL, which includes the end effect and step-in with discontinuities. The lengths of the microstrip were compensated to counteract these non-ideal effects. The simulated gain and return loss of the compensated filter is shown here. The physical layout was exported from Microwave Office. The low-pass step filter was fabricated with errors. First, the copper was not placed completely flat on the substrate, which can account for some deviation from the simulated values. Second, the copper tape dimensions do not match the simulated values. The fabricated filter was measured and simulated again. The new simulation is closer to the fabricated filter, but it still does not match exactly. The same goes for the low-pass step filter. The copper tape is scrunched up in some of the thinner sections and not uniformly flat. Like the low-pass step filter, the fabricated filter was measured and re-simulated. The new simulation does not match the fabricated results exactly either. The remaining errors may be accounted for in other fabrication mistakes, such as soldering technique and other miscellaneous details. The coupled bandpass filter was designed with errors. Due to these flaws, the results are skewed. The fabrication of this filter was fine, though. This particular filter was fabricated 3 times and it yielded the same S01 and S21 values each time.
let it keep going.
I'm gonna get that audio in there.
No!
We're gonna auto-tune it so it make a song out of it. Calibrate.
It was fabricated with errors. First, the copper was not placed completely flat on the substrate, which can account for some deviation from the simulated values.
That was the awkward position.
What the
Oh, sorry.
God.
Don't you forget about me.